Hi everyone.
Hello.
Hello. Everyone over on Twitch and on TikTok and nowhere else, apparently.
Nowhere else. You are getting exclusive content right now.
Yep. Streamlabs has decided that nowhere else is allowed to stream today. But hello, Purificino. Hi, Michael. Thank you for the dongers.
I wonder if it's our subscription.
No, I don't know. Hi, Meg. Hello to the Givy Goblin. Hi, Purificino. Hi, Mitiani. Hi, Falcon. Hi, Snipes. Abhorrent Beast, thank you for the follow. Hi, Niche, JG, one-time Golden Donger Award winner. Hi, Lace.
There is no Johnny giveaway.
Figured you put too many O's in your comments, so TikTok deleted it. TikTok doesn't like O's.
Nope.
You can't spell TikTok without an O. Just one, though.
Only the one.
Thank you for all those Givy Goblin emotes. Is there a Givy Goblin to Givy Goblin? Is there a givy to goblin?
I'm not giving a goblin away.
You could do. We probably got some in D&D or something.
Oh, that means effort, though. That means I've got to look for a goblin. And then I've got to set up a giveaway for the goblin, for the givy goblins to nab.
Yep. There's an issue with multi-streaming, apparently. So no YouTube or Facebook today. Just Twitch and TikTok.
Just the tease.
TTs. Over 1,000 packs and still missing 10. Oh, 10. It is 10, yeah?
I think so. I haven't counted it again. I got 4 on this page, so. Okay. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. I know you're all here for the counting content. 5.
You like the green with the black background and the emote?
6. 7. No, maybe it's 7. Wow. Oh, no. 8. Yeah,
eight?
You were right.
8.
8.
I thought it was 9, to be fair.
Well, I remembered getting the Palafin yesterday, and I ticked that off this morning because I forgot to tick it off yesterday.
Hi, Elaine. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for subbing yesterday as well. Really appreciate that. Sprouty, thank you for the follow. How are we doing? How are you doing?
Yeah, good. It's nice to have you back in the studio.
Thanks. It's nice to be back in the studio. It was all right at home. But it's good to be back. Givy goblins are a real infestation.
Yeah.
You let rip at one on another live selling app and now you're banned.
Oh.
Well, that's what you get for letting rip during a stream. I just don't. Yeah, it's hold just, it in.
Hold it in.
Zero, thank you for the what is that? Potatoes in what?
Potatoes in love?
Potatoes in love.
Potatoes in love.
Yep.
Yeah.
Apparently.
Oh, I had jacket potato for dinner last night.
It's good.
Very good.
What did you have on it?
I just had butter on it.
Okay. I thought you were just going to say, I just had nothing.
No. So.
I need a bin.
Oh, yeah, because I tidied. Yeah, so I had jacket potato and sausage with hummus.
Nice.
And then we did a round 2 wrap of vegetable burgers and basically like a fake kofta. It was nice. It was a very much a freezer dinner kind of evening, but the jacket potatoes had been in for a couple of hours. They were fresh, not frozen. Of course, we're on Food Talk, Linda.
Yep. Also, you said sausage. I got very excited, but then I realised.
Yeah, I know.
Not a real sausage.
No. Or they're the Richmond meat-free ones, so they are as close to a...
To be fair, better than the Richmond sausages.
There you go.
But that's not a difficult...
Do you classify as a goblin? You're only here for a freebie. Well,
that you are a givy goblin.
Yeah, welcome.
Although Meg is the queen.
Yeah.
She's my queen. Just like Jon Snow in the last season of Game of Thrones. Speaking of Game of Thrones, new Game of Thrones stuff coming out. Song of Ice and Fire Tactics set to come out February 8th on Kickstarter. And the Night Models Game of Thrones miniatures game, which will actually feature Kit Harington's Jon Snow.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because normally
it's based on the TV show.
Normally it's a little bit of off-brand. You're right there.
Yeah, I'm just getting comfortable.
Sausages for tea, Linda. Great shout.
Can Richmond legally call those things sausages? You thought they were made of sawdust. A lot of them are. A lot of products are made with bits of sawdust in.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yeah. I was like, what? Where are we going with the sawdust? Yeah.
A lot of those food products actually have sawdust or something that is used in sawdust in them.
Yeah.
Which is weird. You're looking forward to the new Paldean Fates boxes?
Yeah.
Yep. We've got the booster bundles coming out in a few weeks' time. Next week, we've got the tins coming out, the mini tins as well. So hopefully we'll be able to open a few of those.
Those mini tins are so cute.
Mini tins are always great.
I love them. I don't use them for storage, but I feel like I should.
How tall can we get the tower today? Not that tall.
No.
Like I put in the harpsichord afterwards, I'm the sensible one, apparently.
Yeah.
It's like, not the single cards.
No. I spoke to my other half when I got home and said that I'd made the tower taller than myself. And his visible reaction was, you fool. Like, how did that not fall over?
Hi, Oisin. How you doing?
Yeah, I mean, that's fair.
But you could stay. You're Ian.
Yeah, you could.
You could stay. We would appreciate it if you stayed.
Yeah, so I think we've opened 1,128.
Yeah.
I think, because I feel like I opened 228 yesterday, because I got the 8 in my head. And
Jump off?
We've got all the greens. Okay. Got all of the grass types, apart from Capsicid and Relo.
I need to turn the autofocus back off.
Amazing, Beth. Thank you so much. And thank you for joining us on Twitch.
Yeah, really appreciate that, Beth.
Will we be getting Cyber Judge on the site? I'm going to assume that's
Cyber Judge. What is Cyber Judge?
I assume Yu-Gi-Oh.
I have no idea what Cyber Judge is.
Oh.
All right, autofocus is off. Woo.
And you've zoomed back in.
You can zoom.
Zoom! There
you go. Hi, Sophie. How's it going?
Yeah, so I think we're missing 8. We are missing 8. I counted 9. Yeah. So we're looking for Capsicid and Relor out of the grass type.
I thought you said we were done with the green.
Yeah, me too, but we're not. And we're looking for Slowpoke and Wigglet out of
Charizard.
Water.
Water?
Water.
Water. It's a Japanese Pokemon set. Well, if it's Japanese, then we won't get it, unfortunately. We only do the English TCG releases currently.
Exciting. It reminds me of Judge Dredd, reminds is what I'm picturing.
Of Judge Man from Yu-Gi-Oh. Yeah. Right, we have a Cyclozar.
But we will let the people who are in charge of the buying know that you are after Japanese sets. Never know, might do it in the future.
Yeah.
Europe.
Zatu. Yeah. Slowpoke.
Yeah, we haven't got the shiny Slowpoke.
We don't have the shiny Slowpoke.
No.
Did everyone answer Meg's question of what everyone's having for dinner?
No. Oh. No, I think Linda said sausages.
Ah, sausages are good. Real sausages.
Yeah. No, obvious.
Actual sausages.
Actual sausages. Made with real sausage.
Meat.
I think I'm having... Well, I'm in charge of my own dinner tonight, so I'm just cooking for me.
Ah, shepherd's pie. Nice. Purified chino. Yurian, at least we sent it sealed. Some people rip it with their dirty fingers. Like, who wants that?
I mean, we're...
I agree.
We're not a rip and chip.
We're not a rip and chip, yeah. Although, we got Wattrel. Well, no, we need killer, yes. We need Killer Wattrel.
We do need Killer Wattrel, but Wattrel's still quite exciting. There.
We will, you know, touch them with our hands and then they go for single cards, but...
It's a different kind of touch.
Yeah, they have to be open for the single cards.
Ooh, a Sunday roast on a Wednesday. So a Wednesday roast.
Very nice. Yeah. Lasagna sounds great, Sophie. Chicken, vegetables, and suet dumplings in a slow cooker. Suet dumplings are great, though. I haven't had suet dumplings in a while.
I don't think I've ever made them.
Clod. No. I've only had suet dumplings and suet pudding and stuff like that. So when I... In my old recipes, looked at suet. I'm like, there's like the little circle things that you get out of a packet. No, it's fat.
Yeah. It's, although if you, I'm now thinking if you'd tried to make a recipe, you'd picked up the suet, the little like dumplings.
Yeah.
And it was like, well, this makes no sense. Mix this in with more flour. What is this?
Meg doesn't mind people ripping her packs on whatnot. It's fair. Mm. Then you've got some nostalgics too, which we do have some over on the online store on the TikTok shop.
Purified Chino, if you leave the live and come back in, our voices may return to normal.
Yep. Or you can keep them that way and maybe you'll like it. I don't know.
Bit of entertainment.
Yep. Bit of light entertainment. The helium light.
I assume that our voices are lower this time.
Oh, because a bit of low entertainment. That thing makes more sense.
Yeah.
But yeah, we ain't no rip and ship. You can pick up everything sealed over on the online store in the TikTok shop. We got a poor me.
Oh, poor me.
Our voices are so deep.
Deep.
Maybe if we do really high voices to compensate for them going low.
Sophie. I mean, my voice is quite high anyway.
True.
The low voices are funny. It's all good. That's what we're here for. Your entertainment.
Tell them about the singles, the hottest singles in your area.
I mean, Abra, it wouldn't be my top choice for a hottest single.
No? You would swipe right.
I guess I'm swiping right.
Hi, Adele. How's it going? Sounded like an anime character, if you want a comparison. An anime female, like an anime girl in a school being very shocked.
Yeah.
We're talking about anime earlier today, weren't we?
We were. Yeah, I'm probably going to... So, I did my own dinner.
Yep.
I've got the TV to myself, so I'm probably going to try and finish the One Piece live action.
Okay, nice.
Because, yeah.
You're going to watch the Avatar one when it comes out on Netflix? Do you care about Avatar?
I don't know. I never really got into Avatar, but that doesn't necessarily mean that I shouldn't revisit it as a more grown up.
Hi, Matthew. How's it going?
Sophie, so the One Piece Netflix series, really good, really fun. Obviously, the original is many, many, many installments in terms of reading it. So it is completely up to you with that. Ajin, you pulled Poor Me and Baby Shiny Little Chonk.
That's right. We've already had it. But yeah, very nice, Ajin.
Still missing 1P cards, probably. I mean,
well, we're missing the shinies, and the shiny rares aren't too bad. I think that John was saying they're like 5 quid each or something. You grabbed the One Piece double pack from the web store today. Amazing stuff. Did you get anything else? Sophie, you were starting to you're hoping to start with the Netflix version.
I would
just do that, do a season and then keep up with that, because that seems to be hitting more and more seasons.
Yeah, and I think trying to go back for however many decades of it is a bit scary.
Kenzie, thank you for the flame heart. Matt, thank you for the lightning bolts as well, really appreciate that. Make sure to enter the giveaway for your chance to get some Paldean Fates.
Yeah,
I'm assuming that's what we're giving away.
Yeah, the tech sticker. Yeah. Nope.
Thank you for the treasure box as well, Matt. Really appreciate that.
Oh,
enjoy the treasure.
Keep getting the Funko emails. They keep sending me Batman ones.
No. Well, you got some behind you.
It's like they know.
Sophie, you put in a £210 pre-order yesterday and used £10 credit from your purchases. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that. I assume for Temporal Fates. Or for maybe some Paldean Fates, Temporal Forces, or some Paldean Fates stuff coming out soon.
I was about to correct you, but you caught yourself.
Temporal Fates. Hi, Cozy. How's it going?
We did another 3-player Lorcana game today. Had to stop, had to think, made sure that was there. Do we get anything from the treasure boxes?
Treasure, gold, money.
Pieces of eight.
No, we need Dodrio.
Dodrio, fell for that.
And we have a Tinglu gold rare, but we need the Chiyu.
Johnny, obviously. But I feel like the other player was at a disadvantage with playing with one of my homebrew decks.
And for the first time. I will totally get Temporal Forces wrong.
Sorry, treasure box on the TikTok live. That makes more sense. Coins. Ooh, Cozy, you're going to a seal and draft event after Chapter 3 launched.
Nice.
That's exciting. Matt, we haven't pulled the Pikachu yet this stream.
But we have pulled a couple.
Yeah. Adele, which card do you need?
The Dodo? It's green.
Me?
Nice and green. I'm thinking maybe on Inkland's release, because you're thinking of getting a box. I'm thinking of getting a box. Maybe we just do like sealed on release. Maybe in-store release.
Say what?
Sealed.
Like draft.
Yeah. Well, no, sealed, because so sealed is where we have our own packs and we make our deck.
Yep.
Draft would be if we pass the one, two players, it's not worth it.
No.
If there was like eight of us, maybe.
We don't have that many friends.
We don't, no. Clive.
Where is Clive?
Sealed. Scared, excited, totally gonna lose. But you get some cards. And that's the coolest thing about draft and sealed stuff. Very excited for Star Wars Unlimited as well, because they showed off a load of that in draft and sealed too, which is really exciting. You can go there.
I think we got 5 Clives yesterday. It only just overtook Nimona.
Yeah.
And I've realised that you completely upset my top piles of 10.
Yeah, probably.
I can see it.
Your pieces of eight. You can come and watch us do that. Can't afford a box. We probably live it.
Yeah.
If we're allowed to. Actually, we need to double check when we're allowed to start putting out
That's
stuff.
A next week problem.
But yeah, we'll totally live it.
Yeah. Leo, I'm well, thank you. How are you, Johnny?
I'm doing all right. I was a bit tired before stream, but we're getting into the game.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Sizzle?
Yes.
Yep.
Got that.
Caesar. Is shiny just green?
We were looking for Scyther and found Scyther yesterday.
Who is not green?
Yes, is green. Caesar is normally red.
But Scyther's normally green. Thank you for the gift.
Yeah, he's green in this. She, it.
Is it? It's got like pink.
Yeah, pink knees.
Like white stuff. It's only Wednesday. How could it be a next week problem?
Well, I've written Jan 2025 up on the calendar, so you wait until it's next year's problem.
Pumper Giles, thank you for the treasure box as well. Really appreciate that. And another one. You're seeing Maddie from Dicebreaker in Brighton this weekend. Probably play Lorcana. Amazing stuff. Send our love. We
met Maddie, didn't
was
we?
Was it Maddie?
I feel like we played not Scythe.
Expeditions.
Was it with Maddie? So Cozy, if you are looking to visit us, as in us, best thing to do is to go to Folkestone West, and then it's like a 15-minute walk.
Yeah, or let us know.
But for
the shop, Folkestone Central.
Yeah, Folkestone Central, probably again 20 minutes.
Yeah, I'd go with that.
Yeah.
Well done to the winner of the giveaway, and good afternoon, Tom. How you doing?
Somebody won.
Is it zero?
Oh, it is zero.
Zero Valdos, spot on.
I thought you were saying zero. Odd.
Zero?
Like zero winners.
Zero. Yeah, we're not in the shop. This is a studio corner.
This is all an illusion.
Yep. Studio corner. It wouldn't be quiet if it was in the shop. People, no. Was it Wednesday, playing Dragon Ball, Yu-Gi-Oh,
Magic
the Gathering. Yeah, loads of things going on. It wouldn't be quiet. Amazing stuff, Zero. Well done. Thank you for all the gifts that you give us all the time. Really appreciate that. And now we've given one back to you.
Yeah. Or two, it seems.
Or two. Yeah. And thank you for the gifts everyone else is sending as well. Really appreciate that. And that's an example of you know, what you can win.
Mm.
Thank you, Kaisi. You don't know what to think. Gemma, you can come see us.
I assume we're not in the warehouse.
No.
Wow, okay. Maybe we should have been... I feel like we've said we're not at the shop before.
Yeah.
I feel like this is a conversation we've had, folks.
You assumed we were in a secret room of the shop.
Well, we did have a little while of trying to figure out if we could gut the stock room, move all the drinks out and then hide.
Our shop's a big shop, but I think we'd still hear noise.
Yeah. But this is a special space.
Yeah, special space.
I mean, it's invite only for the studio, isn't it?
But like, surely our subs.
Well, this is the thing.
Our lovely subs.
And that's what you get as a... Oh, it's not a basement. We're actually upstairs. The shop is massive, but there's still needs to be enough room for us to natter away. We have live streamed from the shop before.
Yep. Ooh.
Ooh.
It's Corridon. Clefki, we've had.
Cozy, your top secret apartment.
Studio apartment.
Nice.
Planning to come and see us, see if you can help organise the bulk.
Oh, that's good. We'll set you up some flow diagrams. Well, you were attending the live from the comfort of your home. I assume you went out in the shed.
No, I was not. It's cold out there.
He's not banished to the shed. Yeah. Hi, Johto Jake. Thank you for the gifts.
You have an office the size of your wingspan. Not your board game wingspan, or your actual wingspan.
Yeah. Have you got Wormspan?
Scrivelin, no.
No, Capsicid.
I don't think Wormspan has gotten to people yet. I think it's at the distribution stage. So people who ordered it over on the Stonemaier site should be getting it soon.
Oh, I see. I thought people were getting preview copies.
Some people probably have, actually. Mm. You're not wrong. Your pre-order is today. But pre-order is today. Yeah, pre-order is today.
Pre-order today?
Pre-order today. You can also pre-order it over on the online store today.
Yay!
$42.95, I believe. You're a nobody. You're not a nobody.
You're Cozy Board Games.
Yeah. Although, I guess Wingspan makes more sense than Wormspan dragons. I mean, some of the dragons are like baby dragons, but some of them are beastly dragons.
Sorry. That's beastly.
Yeah, beastly.
Not the hand signal that I've seen for beastly before, but we'll use it. But yeah, we're looking forward to. We've recorded the podcast earlier, chatted about the stuff we got up to at Toy Fair.
Hoppip?
No, all good.
Is Meg in the shed? Is that where the Giver Goblin hangs out?
I mean, Meg's been gone a while.
No, Meg's there.
Sophie, it upsets you when we go through the packs upside down. I kept confusing myself yesterday. Couldn't figure out how the packs were ending up upside down.
Oh, I don't do it on purpose, but I do keep going. Lucario.
Lucario.
Do we have a Lucario?
I think we've got Lucario.
Yep. You just got your event with Danny Strandring sorted for UK Games Expo. Amazing stuff.
Fantastic.
We'll see you there.
Yep. Well, hopefully. I assume
we'll. Well, we'll be at UK Games Expo. Probably.
Okay. Yeah.
Probably. Yeah. We haven't sorted out the hotels or any of that stuff yet.
No.
I thought we were supposed to be getting on it quicker this year.
We are. Cozy Chaos. Nice. Well, we have to go.
Yeah, we have to be there then, surely.
Yeah.
Hey? That sounds great. It's a great name.
What's your overall Mew, Iono, and Zard count for this?
I want to say 3 Mews, 1 Iono, 2 Zard. That's my guess. It's around that anyway.
Yeah. Gemma, always welcome. Well, not always welcome. Like, let us know so that we can get the tea and biscuits in.
Yeah, because Gemma's the only local one,
of
I believe.
Of course. Yeah, that makes more sense. I just had a moment of going... Where is Gemma?
The rest, probably UK Games Expo would be a shout.
Oh, well, Chaos Cards Con would be amazing. I think one of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournaments, we rented out the Loosecliff Hall, didn't we?
We did. The only issue is that we're right at the bottom of the country.
Yeah.
So it's a bit difficult. If we're in the middle, say Birmingham for UK Games Expo, could be a better shout. Maybe we'll do, depending on how many people are interested in coming to a chat with us, maybe we'll have to figure out a meet-up. In Birmingham, in the Brums. Hi, Skipper. How's it going?
Hi.
London? London's not the centre of the UK.
London thinks it's the centre of the universe, but it is not. I think, like, actually the middle of the UK is something like around near Sheffield or something crazy. Because I was watching a video and it was showing the north-south divide. And because Scotland is so tall, it kind of puts it... what most people deem to be north.
Was it Map Men? Did you watch Map Men yet? You should watch Map Men.
Maybe it was Map Men.
Maybe you watched Map Men.
Maybe I did.
Sophie, we think we had 2 and I know first day. Maybe we did. Yeah, maybe we did.
But I didn't pull any. Did you get one?
I've had, I want to say, I've definitely had one, maybe 2. Maybe Sophie's got a better memory than I.
Yeah. Midlands for your guess, and Birmingham is what? For what?
4 hours away from Meg.
How?
Is anywhere 4 hours away from Birmingham? We're 4 hours from Birmingham.
Well, it's 3.5, but three. Yeah.
Depends how fast that you're driving.
Well, it takes me 4 to get home and Worcester's 40 minutes on from Birmingham, so.
Mitiani's way up north.
Yeah. You can fly down, though.
Knackley we've had.
Yep.
We'll go in the Chaos Cards jet. That's not going to be good on our carbon footprint.
No, we're going to have to cycle.
As a carbon neutral? Negative?
Neutral.
We're neutral. Carbon neutral. We are carbon neutral.
Yeah. Snipes, how is it possible
Judge.
That so many people are so many different hours from us? Is that 5 hours or Birmingham? Because I'm now confused. Because Snipes, if you're 5 hours away from Birmingham, that puts you up near Mitiani. I keep getting the harpsichord in my head, and then the mitts is there.
Glad you're doing good, Skipper.
Oh, you're talking about Birmingham, okay. You're 5 hours away from the Chaos Cards. Okay, thank you everyone for clarifying as well.
How far is everyone away from Birmingham?
Yeah, let's go for Birmingham.
Birmingham is closer to the Midlands.
I don't want to call mitts, Dad.
Cozy, you're not too far from the shop, apparently direct train from London Bridge. Yep, you got the high speed. That is the way.
That is, high speed is from St Pancras.
Oh.
London Bridge is the 2.5 hour train, but beautiful views.
Is it? Could you not just go to St Pancras?
You could go to, but and maybe Cozy
speed,
doesn't want to.
Speed train.
Maybe Cozy wants to save her money.
High speed.
High speed.
High speed. Can't go to France. Well, you can go to France from there.
Yeah, you could.
Just not from Ashford.
No.
It's quite sad. Adele, you're about an hour away from Birmingham.
Birmingham.
Zero's 2 hours. Bobby's 4 hours.
Yeah, Cozy, go for... You can actually go to Brighton from Ashford, though.
But we do I not have to go into London first?
No. Oh. They do a change. It's the same platform as the London Victoria train. Really confused me. Mm. But much cheaper than going into London.
Blackpool for Tom.
Ooh.
Adam, you don't know all these southern places.
I love that everyone's giving us radiuses. Radii? Radius.
Radius. Radius. Right. Sophie's 4 hours from the shop, and Quippington, you're 35 minutes on the train away. Ooh. From us or from Birmingham?
I feel like we are having to specify. Which location is it?
Jimmy, you have no idea how long it would take for us to get for you to get to Brummy. Well, we pick you up along the way, really. We go past Maidstone.
Yeah, well, did we stop off?
We did stop in Maidstone, I think.
Yeah.
You can get to France quicker than our shop from Leeds Airport. Yeah, true. Down 3 hours to the Cascades top. 1 hour 30 to the NEC.
Mm-hmm.
Mitiani would take about 10 hours to drive to the shop.
Adam, yeah, it would take us less time to get to France than it would for us to get to London or Birmingham.
True. The winner gets to come on and do a live stream.
Well, you know, if we can get the tech to work.
Squovet, we've had.
Yep.
Adele, you're 5 hours from the shop. There's a great fast train to Birmingham from London. You play games on the train to UK Games. I thought about doing that, but it was so busy on the train there and back. We could have played on the way back, but I think we were pretty shattered. On the train to London.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I was like, when did you get the train to UK Games Expo? Was I there?
We didn't last time, did we? Yeah.
We
got a minibus.
We were on the minibus.
Yeah.
Yeah, I drove the year before in the Wenger car.
Yep, the Wenger car. Party car.
Party car. But yeah, we could have definitely done some games. And actually, in all fairness, what Cozy is saying about getting the train up, we could get 1 hour into London, and then is it 2 hours or 2.5 from Euston up to Birmingham?
I feel like it's more expensive though.
I think it is, but also you get the luxury of the high-speed train and then you can just chill out. Yeah. And it goes straight to the NEC as well.
Nice. Choo-choo. Plod.
Plod. Oh, you get car sick. I do too. What is worrying is I get car sick even when I'm driving, which is not good.
Might plan for the 20-hour road trip sometime in June. Just go to UK Games Expo.
Yeah, see us there.
Yeah, it's slightly closer, and also
it'll only be a 12-hour round trip.
You've got other things, not yeah. just us.
I mean, we are awesome, but UK Games Expo is fun as well.
Shall we secretly plan a day to rock up at the Cascade Studio and crash a live stream?
Whoa, I'm not sure I'm ready for different coloured beanies.
Whoa.
I'm not ready.
I only brought one hat last time. I need to get some more from the Chaos Cards online store.
I feel like we might need to do a hat walk,
yeah.
We'll
add it to the merch order.
Yeah.
Flamingo, we've had loads of.
And Mitiani, Everyone's going for the crashing of the live stream.
Yeah. And Purified Chino, I mean, we're not exactly a mom and pop shop in terms of board games and stuff.
I guess not.
Technically.
What are we doing for the Locana launch? We'll probably head down to the shop.
Yeah. We need to double check that we're allowed to show stuff on release. I think we should be. But we'll probably head down to the shop. We'll pick some up and then we'll stream it as normal. Open up some, play sealed maybe. But the shop, I believe, are the shop doing an event? Do you know? I don't remember. They should be.
Yeah.
Because they've been doing some over the last few months. Different things.
We were talking earlier about how there are certain phrases and things you say that just don't quite sound right when you verbalize them. So we were talking about Locana and the ink being wet.
Yep.
And the ink drying now. And I've just seen Tom saying, which I'm assuming is a compliment to Chaos Cards. You're the daddy of mom and pop shops at this point. And it's reminded me of the people who would come on stream and ask us to say specific things.
I'm kind of used to it, Luxio. We've already had, because in wrestling over the past year, 2 years or so, we've had two people, one call themselves Mammy, M-A-M-I, and Daddy. So I feel like I'm relatively desensitized to it at this point. You can get it on shirt too. Cozy attempted to go Dark Sphere, might be manic though. I know Libby went to Dark Sphere to pick up some Disney Lorcana on release of the game, and I think it wasn't too bad, because Dark Sphere is quite big. And they've got other stuff there too, which is quite cool. I've only went in there the first time, I think, a few months ago.
I've just realised that we could coordinate with Box Meeples Cozy, and then we'd be able to have a 5-player Lorcana game.
Wow.
Wow.
Crazy.
Oh, enjoy Hobbycraft, Adele. Can you let me know which fat quarters they got in?
Yeah, they've also got a miniature terrain. Yeah, for train sets. You started your Alan Tudyk deck, and you have 8 cards. Who does Alan Tudyk play in Disney? Apart from K2SO, which technically counts, but it's Star Wars. And there's no Firefly TCG, as far as I'm aware. Do you feel more like Daddy Champa or Daddy Orton? Daddy Orton.
I think a load of kind of thoughts have entered in my brain, and my brain is trying to process them all at once.
Meg's heard worse. Of course you have. You have a potty mouth, Meg. Come on your stream for like 2 minutes. Come on your stream for like 2 minutes and you're going off. Talking about Harry Potter and that. Jeez. Hey, Weaselton. Weaselton? The Duke of Weaselton, Tuk-Tuk, oh, and the goat from Wish.
Yes! Oh. That's why I should know his face.
Yeah. Thanks, Gemma.
Oh, you did tell us this last week, actually.
Yes.
Yeah. Sorry. A Knight's Tale.
Gemma, thank you for the wiggle. We'll purify Chino. Kent is a couple of hours. So tempting. Kent is the garden of the United Kingdom, apparently.
That's what the sign says.
Although you come into Ebbsfleet straight away and it's all building. Thanks, Snipes. Could get to do a D&D live. I mean, so this is the thing. I'd love to do D&D with subs, but it's correlating. Getting everyone together.
Choreographing.
For two or three hours.
I like how your face was like, no, that's dancing, stop.
For 2 or 3 hours. And then also I have to prepare it and all that stuff. So I'd like to do it. It's just getting it all together.
You can't say you're turning up tomorrow is basically what we're saying.
Yeah, within the time and stuff, but
we could do like a D&D stream up at UK Games Expo.
Oh, we could do. Are you going to run it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Amy's going to run it.
I've got like 4 months to plan, right?
Don't procrastinate. Mm. We got the whole poor me, poor mo, poor mot line.
Oh, that's nice.
Cool. Meg's TikTok make her sweet and innocent, but her streams say otherwise. True. True.
Bill.
Real goblin. Cozy, you gotta get ready. Got an Andromeda's Edge
TTS
play tonight. Good luck. Enjoy. Have an amazing evening.
Thank you for coming by and saying hello.
Really appreciate you being popping by.
We just appreciate it.
Glamora.
Glimmit is what we need.
Yep. Well.
Oh. You can do what you like. Yeah, we could do
Finish them we got.
Zoom D&D.
Zoom?
Zoom was suggested.
Zoom?
Zoom.
We've got harpsichord already. We're all in the same group.
Can we do video?
Video call everyone.
Whoa. Although the amount of times I try and use the harpsichord for a call, and it's like, oh, I'll just use my mobile.
I think it's just Andy.
Oh, okay.
Because Andy is like, I'll call you in a minute. And then I'm waiting. I'm like, did you call me? And then I check my phone. Oh, you tried to phone me on Messenger. You were talking to me through the harpsichord. I thought you were just going to video call me through that. The stream can sometimes be tame, Snipes. Meg needs to wear green paint and Dan needs to be ball guy. Yes.
Yep.
You mean you make slurping noises down the mic? Yeah, that was not. I wasn't into that, Snipes. Don't like slurping noises.
No. Is Dan still in the stream? I know his comment was just at the top, but I need to ask a 3D printing related question. So can you let me know if you're still here?
End up looking like the witch and Wizard of Oz. Yeah.
As Gemma, if you like snipe slurping, then you do you. Yeah.
I blame Meg.
Do you blame Meg for everything?
No, just for ASMR and the...
Just wow, just, that was it.
Just the entire genre. No, I blame Popple.
I blame Popple for ASMR. Dan, so I saw on Etsy a 3D printed Cubone skull for a cosplay.
Nice.
And I was really intrigued by it, and I thought, you know who could tell me what it's like to wear a 3D printed headgear?
A 3D printed headgear?
Yeah. Dan. Dan will know.
Hi, Dave.
Tom, thank you as well. So I understand it's lightweight. Do you have to sand down the 3D printed headgear for it to be comfortable? Because all of the 3D printing I've seen has had like little ridges on it and things like that. Anyone can jump in with answers to this. I just know that Dan has had a 3D printed ball guy headgear.
Put a cushion in it. Yeah, true.
With the outside of it as well. Like, because Cubone is wearing a skull and it looks smooth, so I just want to check.
Then sand it. Charmeleon.
But also, I don't have a 3D printer, so it's very much a, like, how does this work? Yeah, the seller should sand it so it's finished. I think you don't wear the outside.
We're talking about Cubone heads, not, like, human skin.
No, I don't want to. I put a giveaway live.
I saw.
Yeah. The seller did sand it, but it was also like 40 quid. And I found myself going, I have more questions. So.
Did you ask the seller?
No.
Oh.
I wanted to ask other people before I looked like an idiot.
Oh.
I like to contain my idiocy to the streams. I don't want people in the outside world realising that I don't know what I'm doing. Whoa, look at all the shares.
Thank you for the shares, Elaine.
I wonder what they're doing next door, because I am worried.
Sanding, maybe. Maybe you ask them.
Yeah, can you sort this out for me? But yeah, when I was trying to figure out the cosplay for Pokemon Day, I fell into a hole.
Yeah.
And an Etsy or eBay or any of those places hole is not a good place to be.
I don't know what I'm doing for Pokemon Day. I don't know what we're doing for stream for Pokemon Day, if I'm honest. I asked John if we got any cool old stuff, and he was like, nah.
Nope. Not for you. Literally fell into a hole. I'm always falling into holes. Always tripping over stuff.
Is there a Pokemon costume shop we can go to?
No.
No?
No, I think they're all internet-based. Open football.
Yeah, match tax. Let's go. Tanamouse.
Wait, I don't want people making files of us. I don't want to be 3D printed around AI, the internet. I mean, you could AI.
AI everything.
Snipes, I don't know what that sentence is, but I don't like it.
You can link me a 30 quid inflatable Pokemon costume of what? Of what? Also inflatable.
Have you seen the space we have here?
Also, you said Pokemon. So hopefully not like Ash's mom. Inflatable Pikachu. We have a Pikachu.
I did wonder about doing a cosplay as like background characters in Pokemon.
Inflatable Wigglet. I'd love to, but they don't make those, unfortunately. If you can make one, I'll wear it.
Please. Oh, you said it.
Yeah. I know there's some very similar things that we could potentially make into a Wigglet. But that requires a little bit more effort than I'm willing to put in. Thanks, Snipes. A muck.
That's just a purple sheet, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, it's easy enough. But I feel like that's too lazy.
I was looking at the... There's loads of penny cosplays now.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
You could do that. Ditto. I mean, that's just a slightly pinker shade of purple sheep.
Or bright blue, if you wanted to go for a shiny. I did see that Pokemon Center's now got a Tandemouse plush.
Nice.
Yeah.
Can we just get a really big plush? Can you get luxury costumes? No, but I saw on Pinterest someone made like a funky hoodie, which is pretty nice.
Yeah.
That's expensive, probably. Mm.
That's the thing. I found some really good stuff, and then I'm like, oh, for the sake of one day, maybe a little bit out of my.
Primate, we've had.
Europe. Thank you for the sharing the live,
Lucario.
Sophie.
Lucario would be cool.
Lucario.
What's the one in Power World that's basically Lucario, but Pharaoh, something?
Electabuzz would be cool.
Get the giant Snorlax plush and pull the stuffing out of it. That's what I thought like we could do, but I think that'd be quite expensive.
Yeah.
Jesse and James.
Yeah, I've got the stuff for Jesse.
I feel like that's lazy though.
All right.
Hi, Holy Shrapnel, how's it going?
Metabee or Greymon at some point, but you need a bigger card.
Yeah. Off-piss, you like the gold cards in the set? What are our thoughts? Hey, it's all right. It's all right, he says.
I mean, the Arcanine scared me with the giant Arcanine plush.
Get the Waylord plush, yeah. I could be standing up Waylord.
I mean, I've dressed as Jesse. I don't think you've done James.
Penny! Second Penny.
Well, that takes the shine off of the one I got yesterday.
Phil swears Mimikyu without his Pikachu outfit.
That is the darkness of the soul that will kill us.
Kangaskhan, if one could get in the pouch.
No, thank you.
Put the Luxray in the pouch.
Yeah, that would be better. I mean, you were going to do Brock.
Yeah, I don't want to be typecast.
You don't want... I can't even...
Also, a frying pan difficult to fit in the backpack.
Does he hang it on the bottom of the rucksack?
I don't know, but I'm not doing that.
Okay.
Reedy, yes, it is all sent sealed. We do not rip and ship. We have individual cards available over on the online store, but everything over on the TikTok shop is sent to you sealed.
Yeah, Misty's an easy costume to do.
No, I'm not dressing as Misty. I don't have a good enough midriff for that.
What I love is that we're sat down, and something that I realised with a lot of, when I was looking at the Iono costumes, she's got like one thigh-high sock and these silver shoes. I'm like, pointless.
Have you seen the cute Iono costume?
Yeah. That's huge sleeves, though.
Yeah?
Like it's...
be difficult to open packs.
It's like shoulderless.
Yeah.
And just these huge sleeves and the giant Magnemites on it.
Holy Shrapnel, it's dark and raining there.
Oh.
Sad times. I don't know what it's like outside here because I can't see the outside.
No. I think it is dark now. There was daylight earlier. It was
gloom we've had.
Anytime I hear the steps on metal, I feel like I must look like a guard dog or something. I'm like, what's that?
Palafin there and Squover again. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just looking at things that would be relatively easy to...
I mean, Paldean students.
Yeah.
Holy Seraphimon, I feel like you're now in a 90s music video where it's a little bit sad and you're seeing the rain fall down the window.
Yeah, but it's okay because at the end of the song, it'll kind of elevate. You'll change the key.
The sun will come out.
It will be good.
Yeah.
What's
Scooby Gang. Yeah.
You once dressed up as Elsa for Halloween. Tom, is that an easy costume? I don't have a blue dress. Does she wear blue?
Yeah.
Or a blonde wig. Or snow powers.
Oh, I can't believe that's the obstacle that is getting in your way.
Yeah, snow powers. Don't have them.
Yeah.
Victini, thank you for the share of the life.
I also kept looking at Sabrina.
The teenage witch?
No, the gym leader. He may have some snow powers.
Because I typed in Pokemon costumes into Pinterest, actually, and I think the fifth result was Sonic. So maybe I'll come as Sonic.
Yep. That well-known Pokemon.
Yep.
I was saying to you earlier, the costume I think I'm going to go with is... I saw on Pinterest and I was like, that is genius. That will do nicely.
Gold Engo? Paint me gold.
You could be a giant cheese string.
Yeah. There must be cheese string costumes, right? Just spray them gold.
Sorry, come on. That is an oddly specific question. But yeah, hopefully.
You hopefully know what.
Yeah, well,
the gold membership.
I need to get confirmation of what they are, because although I create them, I have to get approval still.
Snipes, you've only got 2 full weeks left of work left at your current workplace. Amazing stuff. Hopefully, you can hack it.
I don't actually hack it. That would be bad.
Hack it.
Hack it. Yeah, so Holy Seraphmon, it will probably be money off of the basket. We're trying to make a lot of the codes a little bit more generic because we got a lot of feedback saying don't make it too specific.
I'm looking up cheese string costumes.
Of course you are.
There's a lot of cheese costumes.
Yes.
But no cheese string costumes.
I mean...
None that I can buy anyway.
You could probably do a Jinx costume if you really wanted to go all out.
I could buy a squeezy cheese can costume.
Squeezy cheese can?
I could buy a cheese and cracker double set.
Yeah?
You could be the cracker, I could be the cheese.
Neuvern EX there. I don't know.
There's a red wine and cheese costume.
I mean, wine and cheese, yes.
There is a cheese... There's a cracker with actual squeezy cheese on it as a costume.
It's a two-person costume.
No, that's one. Just one.
Yeah.
That two-person one would be ridiculous.
Please don't be a jinx.
There's cheese ball. There is queso.
I mean, the... Yeah.
Well, how is there not a cheese string costume? Well, there's a mac and cheese costume.
Maybe it's protected.
Yeah, but...
You know what would be good? The inflatable dancing people. That, as a yellow costume, would probably do the job. Holy Seraphmon, I can't say right now. But... Yeah, today is the last day to use the January code. So, yeah, it's completely up to you. Mitiani slowly buying up loads of the MetaZoo. So you should be platinum.
Enjoy, we've got loads of singles over on the online store. How are you finding it? Because I saw some in my dead trading card group that some people are putting up the MetaZoo for sale now.
Really?
Yeah.
What I admire is that there must be people who go, oh, I guess this lives here now. Mew EX there.
There's some pseudo-wudo costumes.
I keep thinking a Wobbuffet costume.
Wobbuffet would be great.
Yeah. Because I didn't realise that the female Wobbuffet has lipstick on.
Okay, didn't know that.
No, I only found out through Pokemon Sleep, which really confused me as a general...
There's a Winnie the Pooh costume.
Not a Pokemon. Yeah. Early Seraphmon, worth taking a chance. Sticklazar. Amy could be Jesse and Johnny could be Wobbuffet. Yeah. I can reuse my Jesse.
Oh, would that? Well, we'd have to spray it gold a bit.
Yeah, that would work. I mean, we must have a gold spray paint.
What do you think?
Body socks. That's never.
Yep. This looks like a pencil.
Toadstool EX.
There's a donut costume.
Sophie's saying yes. Hi, Tony.
There's a giraffe.
Whoa, Dave. That's good. I'm not sure I can say that out loud, but good. Do the odd opening, but want to keep a sealed item of each. Yeah, we opened MetaZoo, I think, a couple of times, but... Ooh, Pikachu!
Nice! I'll chuck that in a sleeve in the top loader.
Boop.
Thank you for sharing the live, everyone. Really appreciate that.
Beautiful.
Maybe I'll just plaster a Paris around myself. I was watching an episode on the buses yesterday. Stan was making his own homebrew. And I remember watching this episode, but they added in a plaster of Paris into the mixture, to making the beer and stuff. Because apparently, they used to use it, and maybe even still use it, to harden soft water. Like a small amount of plaster of Paris.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense.
Not like loads.
So when you're cooking, you can use egg whites to create a raft,
yeah,
and things like that to get all of the sediment and things. And that's where I thought you were going with the plaster of Paris. And I'm like, no, that must be bad.
Or a choreo we've had.
Boop, boop, boop.
Thank you, Snipes of the Rose. Yeah, I had a good day at home yesterday. I was doing the work, but also got to watch TV in the peripheral. Namona.
Ooh, what TV did you watch in the
peripheral? I say TV, it wasn't TV.
Okay.
See you later, Meg. Enjoy Last of Us. Enjoy swearing.
Rude.
Rude. Language. Holy Shrapnel on the Chaos Cards web store keeps wanting to verify you're human. You're still trying to verify that yourself.
Yeah.
Well, good luck. Language.
That's Captain America, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm sure many other people have said over. Just had a call about your fictional car accident you recently had, but wasn't aware of. Well, you know, you could have claimed for some of the insurance.
Definitely wasn't Fifth Element.
I don't know what... Dash Bomb we've had. Yeah, so in my peripheral, I was watching the Fast and Furious 7 Extended Edition, which is only about 2 minutes longer than the normal edition.
Oh, what was included in those 2 minutes?
Some extra, like... words, some extra sentences at the beginning.
Words, really?
Some extra shots of, I can't remember the name. He is the actor who was in Big Trouble in Little China. Can't remember the name. What's your name? He's in Guardians 2.
Congratulations, Snipes, on getting that One Piece as well.
What's your name? He plays Mr. Nobody in Furious 7, which is another reason why I can't remember his name. but he shoots some more people. Well done to the winner of the giveaway.
Who are you?
Groot. It's not Groot.
Laura. Yeah, mentally, I did ask about, but we haven't got an ETA on it.
Not Dave Bautista. Mm-mm. We have Mimikyu. Batista Bomb. Yeah, that was, 10 years ago now that Batista came back to WWE. Kurt Russell, yes, thank you. Ditto, nice. You spoke to someone again today, earliest they're anticipating is July. For One Piece, that's fair. Lois Matt, thank you for the roses. You remember him arriving? So when I was getting into wrestling, Batista was kind of on top. I know he had like an off and on because he was injured all the time and stuff like that, but he came back to WWE in 2014. And then he won the Rumble and everyone booed him. Boo, you're not popular enough yet.
Let's get ready to Rumble.
We've got both OP6 and OP7 in the meantime, so you can still get your picks. Fingers crossed. And hopefully we'll be able to open some as well. Hopip. Yeah, Furious 7 was good. It's always good. The ending is great.
Which is your favourite Fast and Furious?
Furious 7.
Oh.
It's the only one I've got on Blu-ray.
Oh, okay. So
it is my favourite. It's the best.
I wasn't asking which was your favorite that you own, just more.
It's the only one I own on physical, and it's the only one I'll probably own on physical. I do enjoy Furious 1, 2, and 3.
I've lost Tom's comment.
Yeah.
Ugh.
God of what?
Oh, Tom's gone. Bye, Tom.
Yeah, Tokyo Drift, 3. 3. I genuinely like Tokyo Drift. It was probably the first Fast and Furious film I actually watched. So I like it quite a bit. 4 is probably my least favourite. 5 is fine. It's pretty good. 6 is alright. 7 is the best. 8 is okay. Sorry, The Fate of the Furious. 9 is pretty good as well. 10, it's fine. So we'll see what happens when the next one comes out in 2025, I think. But yeah, I don't mind if it's not racing based. Moriadon, Gold Rare. There's only 2 Fast and Furious films, Lies, Deception.
How have you got 3?
Yeah, I know, right?
Dang.
Yeah, Furious 1 is good though. Furious 2 is, I really like Furious 2. It's great.
So it's Fast and Furious,
The Fast and The Furious.
Yep. And then The Fast and the Furious 2.
No. Too Fast, Too Furious.
Oh, of course. I knew there was a 2 in there, but I wasn't sure where it was going to... And then what did they do for 3?
The Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift.
Oh, okay. So there was no 3 in there.
Then there's Fast and Furious. Then there's Fast 5.
Yeah.
Then there's Fast and Furious 6.
Yeah.
Then there's Furious 7. Then The Fate of the Furious. Then F9, The Fast Saga.
The Fast Saga?
Then Fast X.
Which isn't the same as Saw X.
No. But they both came out in the same year. Holy Triathlon, do we have any news on the Ultra Pro Premium soft sleeves being restocked? Not sure. Sign up stock notifications. We do have the Fenrir soft sleeves as well in the meantime. ID42. Oh, Independence Day. I actually haven't seen the original Independence Day yet still.
Really?
No. Oh. Tokyo Drift is your favourite. Interesting decision there, Snipes. I like it. I like that it's kind of separate. I like that it's in a whole new place. I'm not too fussed about some bits of it. And I like the wackiness of the future ones. The next one is, there's nothing faster than family. You don't even believe I'm real. You just like the cars and the setting.
Definitely real.
I like that they retroactively made Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift happen in 2015. Because it came out in like 2003, 2004.
But they used
They used flip phones and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But then in Furious 7, they go to Tokyo and meet the guy. And it's like, hey, we just had this race. It's pretty cool, huh? And so technically, Tokyo Drift happened in like 2015.
Confusing.
You don't like the main actor in Tokyo Drift? He's in Lucas Black. He's in a load of NCIS and some of those other shows. Apparently, he's all right.
Lucas Black?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah. He's right. I like him. They missed the chance with fasten your seatbelts. Fasten your seatbelts. Just as in that role, that's fair. I haven't properly watched Independence Day. I've seen a bit. But that I haven't seen a lot of films. Taurus we've had.
What I find interesting is you've seen the films that our community cares about. In the mass, like, you've seen The Lord of the Rings, you've seen Star Wars and things like that. Then every so often somebody goes, sorry, what? How have you not seen this? It's like, do you know how many films there are
out in the world? Yeah, there's loads of films. I don't know what a big one is. I haven't seen Frozen. Yeah, that's a big one.
Yeah, but that's understandable
as well. Is it, though? I haven't seen Avatar 2. That's, like, one of the biggest money-making films of all time. I saw the original Avatar once, and I don't remember anything about it, but I feel like most people are in that position.
I feel like that's an Ultra 4K.
Clive! I am not getting Avatar on Ultra 4K. Taking a stand.
I remember when Avatar came out, people were like, wow, and it was on all the TVs in the like shops for showing how crisp.
And it made the most money and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But barely anyone remembers anything that happened in it.
Blue people.
Blue people. They touch the tips.
Not gonna go on that. As Zero saying, watch Frozen, can imagine you singing along to it. Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't?
I know some of the songs for it.
Yeah.
But I haven't actually seen the game properly. Wiggle, 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 Jammer. Nimona?
You still haven't seen Sister Act, have you?
No.
Are you still having to rehearse that?
No, it got cancelled.
Oh.
The teacher who was going to do it can't do it anymore. And there are no other teachers who can direct it, apparently.
Wow.
So not happening, unfortunately, which is quite sad.
That is quite sad, actually. Yeah. Although somehow very fitting of Sister Act.
I can tell you everything that happens in it.
Yeah.
I've never seen it. I've read it.
You know it.
Several times.
Yes, Gemma. That is what Johnny does post-stream. So the 8 cards that we're missing, Kilowattrel. We are missing Glimmit.
Gemma, my sister was going to perform it, not me.
Dodrio. Why ruin the illusion?
UK Games Expo, one night only, Sister Acts, as performed by Chaos Cards.
Oh, no. Although I imagine Lee would be all over that. Slowpoke, Wiglet, Relor and Capsicid. The acoustics are terrible in the shed, Gemma. Sorry, I'm really disappointed, actually, because...
Yeah. Yeah, that's a shame. Abomasnow, we've had...
Yeah.
What other big films, I guess, haven't I seen?
You haven't seen Toy Story 3 or 4?
I haven't seen either, yeah, 3 or 4. But I'm trying to think of them, like, because in my head, the biggest ones are, like, the ones that made the most money. That's the lists I've seen. It's like Avatar, Titanic. I've seen Titanic. What else is up there? Avengers Endgame. Harry Potter, the last one, which I've seen.
Holy Spirit.
Wiggle it! Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle!
I'm going to clip that. Like, how is your work environment? Wiggle it!
We don't have a Codex Zipster binder, unfortunately, here with us.
No, it was the DM screen.
Yeah, we got the DM screen, but yeah, not the binder, unfortunately. We don't have everything. But we got Wigglet.
I've done it.
You did it.
I've crossed it off.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
So we're just missing Slowpoke.
And the 7 other cards.
Yeah, Capsicid, Relor.
Did that the wrong way around.
We've only got the one water to get.
Student.
Oh, yeah, Slowpoke.
Slow. Could we acquire one for showing?
We probably could. Not right now, because that involves...
Do you want to order one?
Venturing to the website. Not the website. The other one. You know, the big building.
Actually, while you're there, you can check the Flesh and Blood, if possible. Because if... Oh, no, no, actually, we're getting on separately, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Let's have a look.
But if I know Dragon Shield, then normally the Dragon Shield ones are pretty thick and chunky and very nice texture on the outside. Codex Zipster binder.
Is there a particular colour you're after while I'm here?
They get you that in a shade of red?
Regular blood red.
Oh, just regular blood.
It does go on to say regular midnight blue, but I'm like, regular blood red.
Regular midnight? Mm. Are regular midnights blue? That's a geary.
That is a question.
Yeah, they're black. Pitch.
Higher or lower? Yeah, so there's iron grey, ashen white.
I haven't seen It's a Wonderful Life.
Me neither.
I haven't seen Citizen Kane.
Don't know.
I haven't seen 12 Angry Men. Iron Grey.
You want to see how it compares? Does that mean I have to get the other one as well?
Miss Bathra.
Iron Grey. Oh, we don't have the other one, so... Yeah, I don't think we have the other one, so I don't know whether that comparison will be helpful.
Mm.
I can only apologise for it. I
haven't seen Terminator.
Yeah, that should be on your list, though.
It should be. I want to get it in Ultra 4K. Haven't seen...
So I had a look for Fifth Element in Ultra 4K.
Yeah.
So I was like, I wonder. So the normal Fifth Element, bog standard, DVD.
Pineco.
Like $5.97, brand new.
Yep. I don't know where this is going.
Ultra 4K?
Yep.
£20.
That is cheap.
That is cheap.
Every Ultra 4K I want is like 30, 35 quid.
But I bought a special edition normal DVD and I was like, $12.99, that's a push.
Yeah.
And then I was like, the Ultra 4K that I don't know whether it's physically possible for... there to be anything that is a higher quality. Spaceballs, yes.
Haven't seen.
Oh. Nope. You would enjoy.
I'm sure I would. Yeah. Just haven't seen it.
No. Right. What am I doing? I'm multitasking badly. Oh, somebody is pinning. Thanks. Thanks, team. I don't think it's got Kevin Spacey in it. Got the guy who did Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. and Little Shop of Horrors.
I have seen Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. It was on Disney Channel all the time.
So Holy Seraph Mom, do you want us to show off the binder even though we haven't got the old one? Nope, I've not seen it either. Have you watched all Kevin Spacey films?
That's right.
If it's not a Capsicid, a Rello, or a Slowpoke, I'm not interested.
Have you been on the ride in Disneyland when they had it? The Kevin Spacey ride?
Or Spaceballs.
Spaceballs, I'm guessing.
I hope so.
Sizzle, nice, and another Clive.
Ooh, two have a hotel Clives.
There we go.
I think I shrunk the kids. Weirdly, that wasn't the ride I expected.
No, I always think Spaceballs.
I like the idea of having the Star Wars stuff and then Spaceballs.
What's
next
the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids ride? Is that just You're Tiny? That was a... what was it? That was that. Can't think. Oh, it was Toy Story. They did Andy's Room.
Yes.
And so you could go in there as like a toy.
That wasn't the sentence I expected. I mean, yeah. Oh, dear.
I've never been to Disneyland.
Me neither. So the likelihood of me going on the ride is even slimmer.
Went to Legoland.
Got your license.
Yep. I'm not the biggest fan of some of the Star Wars stuff coming out. I've been recently replaying Knights of the Old Republic 2, and it is so good. That game is so good. It's so good.
Hi, Rob.
It's ridiculous how good that game is. It's so interesting because you've got the light side and the dark side of the Force all kind of working together in this really interesting time in the Star Wars universe. But then you've got really interesting interactions with people who know nothing about the Jedi or the Sith, who are like, oh, there's just these Force users blowing up planets. I don't care. I just want to get on with my life. And it's this kind of area that is it's not explored in the Star Wars universe, which is great. You got all these different alien races. Oh, Arvin, we're getting all the special illustration rest today.
I'll say it once and I'll say it again. If it's not Capsicid, Relor, or Slowpoke, I don't care.
You say Star Wars and you turn off instantly. I'm sorry. Is that an ick?
Still like to see that one. Cool. Yeah, Holy Seraph Mon, I can sort that. Because you can do a little short on it or someone, or we can just take pictures.
Or we can put our Disney card in it. Shinks.
No.
Yeah, it's an ick.
I mean, if you want to acquire it, that's a different conversation.
You don't get the hype about Star Wars. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't either if I looked at it today. But Star Wars Unlimited should be good.
You got told doing your own washing is an ick.
The icks on TikTok is ridiculous. Breathing is an ick. I mean, walking upstairs.
There are some breathing that I'm like, nobody needs to hear that.
Napping during the day.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So many. Mariah Don again.
See, I was listening to the radio, and have you seen at all? It might not fall in your like random feeds and stuff.
No.
Things that women in literature have died from.
Okay, no.
And this morning on the radio, they were doing things that modern women would die from.
Yep.
So, like, in the literature one, it's like parents being happy, dead. All of these things, and then they were going through it. It's like, oh.
Danny, you were the same. You didn't understand the fascination, but now you love Star Wars.
So it's things like fake tan fading. That was how. Death by unsolicited anatomy pictures. Ah, wow.
That's a good way of putting that. Thanks, Dave.
I'm with you now. Yeah. I was like, wow, that is a really niche thing. No. Wiggle. Exactly that.
But yeah, maybe you just need to wait for the right Star Wars media to come out for you. I know, and again, this is going to go back to wrestling because that's what I know about. In that's like, your jam. In like 2015, they made a reality TV show about wrestling. And so that got a whole ton of different people who never knew anything about wrestling to get into the world. So sometimes you just need to find a bit of content that's right for you. You've never used fake tan and never will. Me neither.
Holy Seraphimon, those are very specific requests.
Wore it once for prom, never again. I've never known anyone to use fake tan personally. So like, does that get all over like your bed when you go to sleep at night?
Yeah.
Do you just wake up with orange surrounded like you've eaten a load of Watsits?
Oh, who's been eating Watsits in my bed? So from what I understand, it depends on the type of fake tan. I didn't know that you're meant to like exfoliate and do all of these things so that your skin basically absorbs the tan. So whenever I've done it, it's the equivalent of face paint. So it just goes everywhere.
It's like when it gets under your fingernails and looks like you haven't washed in weeks.
Holy Seraphimon, I believe the folder does come with pages. And it comes with 20 pages, not 25. So...
Sacre bleu.
I don't really know now what to do with this information. Because does that mean we have to get extra pages?
Whooper. Fake tan smells like biscuits?
Mm-hmm. Depends on the fake tan.
Depends on the biscuit.
Why didn't I see that coming? That's the bit that gets me. Why didn't I see that coming?
Ashen White XL.
Sorry. That's you.
The 576 Zipster. That sounds like a car or like a motorbike. The Zipster. The 576 Zipster.
I thought you were after Iron Grey.
Gets you around the town in 24 minutes.
Don't be changing colours on me.
Top speed. 31 miles an hour. What biscuit does it smell like?
I mean, digestives is the one that I had. Maybe if you go more upper class, you get like Viennese Wells and things.
Nice biscuits.
It shows the number of pages in the 576. I think. Yeah, I think I'd just gone with the regular rather than the XL.
Posh fake tan. Yep. It's like posh vapes smell nice. I have no idea. All I see is the shops that sell vapes. And then there's like a bazillion different flavors. I have no idea. Anyway. Ginger snaps? Ginger nuts? Yeah? Is that what fake tan smells like? I've never smelt fake tan either, to be fair. So.
I mean, it's not generally the kind of thing you go around sniffing.
It doesn't come with an additional scent.
I don't think you go down it. It's like, well...
Two in one.
I'm after a deep tan. I'd like it to smell like bourbons.
Capskin.
Hey! Now I'm listening.
Yeah, two in one. Oh, head and shoulders.
That was tan. One of the things that they said modern women don't, like five in one. Like having to use a five in one.
I can't use 10 products when I shower?
No, I need to use, I am having to use one product that does all 10 items. Right. I'm just checking. Wondering if it's worth doing more Dragon Shield stuff.
I mean, I like Dragon Shield stuff, but it just depends.
On stock levels. I'll have a look at it.
Yeah.
I've signed in now, so it'll be saved in a basket.
You signed in, so you're finished.
This is a reminder, your webinar will begin in one day. Nope. Too early. Oh, we're at 26.6k of likes, 30k of likes, and I'll do another giveaway.
Armor Rouge. Knights wears fake tan all the time. I can tell from your streams.
Holy Seraphimon, we can definitely sort that. Sort?
Yeah, you know, you were right.
Yeah.
Would a 10-in-1 be called head, shoulders, knees, and toes? I don't know. We'll get Claudia Winkleman on that.
Oh.
Finished Traitors now, so.
Oh, I could binge that.
Yeah. Poor me.
No, poor you. Yeah, well, you've been doing the builds of the Fenrir boxes as well.
I did one.
You've got another one lined
up. I do.
But.
Mankey.
Holy Serpent, what do you mean product we're actually looking to sell?
The Penguin Bar was for a test.
That was for sale, right? You didn't sell the Penguin Bar?
No. Well, Gemma bought it.
Yeah.
Oh. Sold on eBay too. You're watching Traitors New Zealand, Australia, Canada, and US now. Wow.
Are they everywhere?
If you like the format so much, why not check out Traitors The Card Game? Available on the TikTok shop and the online store.
Very nice.
It is available to play physically, but also via a digital implement, i.e. a smartphone.
I wondered where you're going. It's like, via a digital, okay, implement. Implement, you say. Traitors are everywhere.
How black the iron grey colour is. Well,
I do understand that comment, though, because the petrol is different.
Petrol.
Is different across all of the different ranges, which irritates me.
Off piste, you tried the card game. Your review is as follows. It's okay.
Oh, okay, fine.
I mean, Werewolf is great. Blood and Clock Tower. We still have some. Because I know the shop was someone was asking in the shop if they still had theirs.
Mm-hmm.
I assume we still have some.
Blood, gallons of the stuff. Give more than you can give, and it will never be enough.
Squawkabilly.
Blood.
I realised when I was talking about the kind of gory cards as like a special thing that I'd seen that somewhere else beforehand already. It was the wrestling card game that I've got, which had a special Kickstarter thing where you could spend more money to get gory versions of the cards, which I didn't get. But yeah, it's interesting.
It says we have 12.
Ah, nice. Traitors Australia and US Series 1 and 2 is on BBC iPlayer.
Nice.
But remember, you can only use BBC iPlayer if you've got a TV license.
Yep.
Don Dozo.
Anyone would think that Johnny likes wrestling.
Yeah, it's a shame there's no like board games or card games or anything.
There's
Funko sometimes.
There's like the little boxing dudes. That's the same, right?
There's Funko sometimes.
Yeah. Oh, you did find the wrestling.
Yeah.
Fungos.
A TV license. Yeah, otherwise the TV license police will come round and be like, is there a TV?
I remember moving into uni halls and getting the you need a TV license leaflet and being confused as to whether we needed a TV license for each individual room. Or whether the whole flat would be covered under one TV license.
Yeah.
And I remember going around in circles going, but how many do I need? Oh. Things like that cause me so much unnecessary stress. It's like, you're in a block of 50 flats, say.
Yeah.
Do you need it for the whole property? Do you need it per room? How does that work in a hotel? Do they? I don't know. Just fell in a hole.
Well, it's like the internet and having to do that when you're in uni halls as well.
Ugh.
What was the answer?
So if we counted the flat as one single domestic dwelling, you only needed one license.
But I don't believe that the TV license people have the authority to come into your place. So, or without your permission, obviously. Just get a monitor.
Summarize.
Or don't watch the BBC.
You would like to see what an iron grey Dragon Shield card codec Zipster XL binder filled to just over advertised capacity with Fenrir soft sleeve sleeved cards looks like. I'm glad you brought up Fenrir soft sleeves.
Natu.
$1 million. No.
Haven't seen Austin Powers.
I mean, you're probably doing yourself a favour.
It's in The Adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle, though, and that has Robert De Niro as a villain like that. Some may say I'm winning.
Woohoo! Boop.
Oh, thank you. Wigglytuff.
Pick a card, any card.
So I've also actually, maybe this is a funky one, I've also never seen any of the Planet Earth stuff.
That's very soothing and relaxing at times. What I have discovered, though, is that a lot of nature documentaries are quite gory.
Yeah.
Because, so, Disney, got the kids' profile.
Mm-hmm.
There's a, like, Life on Earth thing.
Yep.
And there is a prehistoric bird getting its throat ripped out.
Lovely.
Yeah, not suitable for a small person.
But yeah, also apparently really good in Ultra 4K.
I bet it is. Mm.
Sausage casserole was very good. Amazing stuff. Did you leave us some?
We'll pick it up from outside the door.
Yep. Uber eats it.
Holy Seraphimon, I do understand the importance of soft sleeves rather than playing sleeves as well, because this is something that you explained to me.
Some people don't, and even though I explained it to you, I think some people left some reviews as well on the Fenris soft sleeves too. They're not for playing with. They are literally for sleeving, putting in boxes or putting in your binder. If you're looking for sleeves for cards that you actually want to play with, Dragon Shields, Ultra Pro, Ultimate Guards, Game Gen X, all those kinds of sleeves are a bit thicker. They'll stay on, they're a bit tighter as well, and they will stay onto your cards.
But it's just quite an interesting thing, because until you start looking into all of these details, you don't... It doesn't really kind of come up in conversation.
For display purposes only? Kind of, yeah. I mean, they're for single cards as well. Soft sleeves are great.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Got a rogue sleeved one in there.
Not rouge.
I was really worried that the sleeved cards in the tower yesterday were going to be my undoing. Mm. That was scary.
Food school?
No, we're always happy to help where we can. It's just on the odd occasion we can't. Like, our customer services team are really good with stuff like that as well. If we can help, we will.
Not going to beat the Tower of Fate, nah. Not doing it.
I was very scared of trying to dismantle that tower. The first staff I took off was too big. And I found myself going, please don't slide.
I don't want to mess up your single cards, just in case.
I honestly have no idea how that didn't collapse. Because I've had small towers collapse quicker than that one.
We've got some light blue top loaders to go with our light blue. Moo.
Moo. Holy Seraphimon, I want to tell you, because you're over there on Twitch and we appreciate you always, but did you know that we've now got memberships over on YouTube?
Dun dun dun.
Mm-hmm.
It's also the Gibby Goblin emote.
Yeah, that made it over to
just
YouTube.
Just for Meg. He's probably over on YouTube or Twitch swearing up a storm.
Hi, only brands. Honestly, the mess you've made with those code cards.
Rice bran. Bran oil.
Bran oil?
Rice bran oil.
Rice bran oil.
Bran flakes.
Not oil of bran.
Bran Stark from Game of Thrones.
Yeah, that's what we're thinking. Bran oil is not... That can't be good. Hi, Gaz. Hi. Dot. Dot? Or would you say full stop?
Full stop?
Is it a stop or a dot?
Dot.
Dot, dot, dash, dash. Oh, interesting.
Do you want to open some cards?
Yeah, I can open some cards.
If you subbed on TikTok, Twitch, and YouTube, does that mean you get 3 entries every month? I don't think so.
No. But there's no reason why that couldn't be possible.
No, just give us more money.
Yeah.
Do you want to open some?
Yeah. I understood the assignment. I just, you know, I'm inherently lazy. Hi! Your code cards are a mess.
They are. But thankfully, they're just code cards.
Lechonk!
Lechonk.
Neuvern EX.
I'll leave that with you for a sec.
You all good? As you trip over. Oh. Man. Off-piste, I don't know. Hopefully it will be. We may also get more stock as well, which is always interesting. I wish I could see into the future, though. You like it here. That's fine, Holy Smurf Mon. We appreciate you being on Twitch, particularly as the multi-stream hasn't been working. So, yeah, we're only on Twitch and TikTok today. And also, there's stuff happening over on the harpsichord that I can't see now because I'm now in front of the screen. There we go. Turn it round for you. What is going on? Tandemouse, Professor's Research. Boop. Oh, the good thing is I can do like a little ASMR over there. The harpsichord. Pop. Doop doop doo. Come on and do the conga. Boop boop boo. Ooh, Fortress EX there. They are so shiny. Bum bum bum. Come on and do the conga. Mods, are you able to put the giveaway live that I've got set up? Yeah, Dan, he just left. He just decided, nah. Have enough of this. You gone, Paldean student there. Lovely cat. Lovely cat. No? I don't know. I can't see. Down tools and round. That's it. Just out of there. You're out. He just left me. That's all. No. Can you put the giveaway live though, I think? Everyone's asking where you are. He was not given a sock. He is only allowed hats. Hi. Hi, Joseph. No socks for you.
No, don't wear socks.
Yeah, Gemma, you were happy with me being here.
Gemma didn't care. True Macedonian.
Yeah, I assume we're at 30k. Anyway.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, we are.
I assume that's why everybody came back to the stream like, yeah, I did my likes. Where's my prize? If you see Johnny give him hats.
Oh. I mean, if you want to.
There were a lot of hats at Expo last year.
Yeah, I need more. Need more hats. Okay.
Oh!
Whoa, Chien.
Dang it!
Chien.
Whoa!
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think the hair's coming off anytime soon.
No, you were saying about it pre Hollybobs.
Yeah, I thought about it. See what happens. Grow it while I have it.
Are you expecting to lose all your hair?
No, but I'm just, you know, that's what Snipe said beforehand.
Yeah, grow it while you have it.
Yeah, just grow it while you have it, yeah. Amy likes squishums. Squishums?
Squishums.
Squishums.
Yep, anything I can squish.
Like the vegetable ones.
Yeah.
I feel very low.
Welcome to my world.
You could be higher.
I could be higher. I don't like being higher, though, because I hit my knees on the table. You can adjust, though, if you want.
Yeah, but then I'd have to adjust everything else. It's fine. Yeah, Snipes' hair is long gone.
Long gone.
Got Widow's Peak. Ah, the Hulk Hogan.
Goldengo.
DJ Ninja, thank you for the treasure box.
You did because of lockdown?
The hair.
Oh, right. Thinking the Squishmallows? That's a very, very niche. Where is Niche?
Niche was here.
Right, you.
Nice. Boop. Make sure to head to that giveaway, everyone. And don't forget to pre-order Pokemon Temporal Forces over on the online store. We've got ETBs coming with the... Oh, I can't remember the name of the things that come with it now. Iron Thorns?
Iron Thorns? They don't sound nice.
Something else?
Hi, JT Jake. Thank you for sharing the live.
People were shocked when it was cut.
How long was your hair before? Because I always say, hey, hi, hi, friends. I always think, like, if you shaved your head, I think that would be quite a shock.
Would it?
Yeah. I think a lot of people are used to your hair being longer than the average bear's.
What if I just do like that?
Oh, no. You live there. I don't know.
The fringe used to go down to your nose.
Yep, classic emo.
Back in secondary school, I used to just eat my hair. That's how far it came down.
I thought that was just I just used to eat it.
Yeah, to be fair. But do you like... Nope. I do have a hairband in there, actually.
Somewhere.
Emo fringe. Yeah, I used to have one of those.
I mean... Oh, pictures are being found. Thank you so much to everyone who is following us as well. Remember, if you enter a giveaway, give us a follow, and then you can get updates when we're next live, and you can enter more giveaways.
There you go.
Short air.
See, it's fine. It's the same. Oh, I've got a little...
Do you remember how angry they got when you shaved your beard off, though?
It's funny. It's probably like a year ago today, or a year ago this month. Soon.
Yeah.
What about... Well, this way.
Ooh.
Got the bubble.
Bubble?
Caught on the bubble.
Gemma's voicing her opinion. Thank you so much for all the gifts as well. We do appreciate it. Boop, 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 boop.
No! Nice.
Don't like it. Hi, Tom. Hi, Charlie. Bye, soft sleeve.
Boop.
Boop.
Thank you for all the gifts. Much appreciated. Meow. Hell's Best Squad. Gifted badge. Number two gifted badge.
End of the day, it's your hair and you do what you wish. Oh.
Who said that?
Gemma.
Lies.
Was there sarcasm in there? Because I know the sarcasm isn't available on TikTok as a filter. Spiritomb. In the harpsichord, you can see snipes with hair. Hi, Claire.
Hi, Claire. How's it going?
Hello to everyone joining through shared invites. Thank you to everyone who is sharing as well. Do you want to go back to opening?
No, it's okay. You can stay there if you want to. It's totally up to you.
I missed my pinning.
Yeah. I mean, if you miss doing whatever you do over here.
Wow. Wow.
Glamora.
Glimmit.
Back when you were rocking a cardigan too, thinking you were cool. Oh. I've never had a cardigan.
Oh, I thought you'd be all over cardigans.
No.
Okay. I go.
Okay.
Oh, you've gone around that way.
We can both go the same way. There's lots of space over here.
Nope, it ruins the illusion. It does feel really low when you go to the higher...
The higher tier?
Yeah. Look at you being in a boy band.
I need to see this.
Oh,
nice. Nice head of hair you got there. When was that?
Wow. Oh. Oh, there was a Instagram stories thing that was like, look at me when I was 21. I'm like, no, thank you. I would like to not revisit those times. 2009.
Nice.
Oh. That seems so long ago.
The duo?
It was so long ago.
Not a dodrio. Move these.
Boop. Hi, Matt. Hi, Ninja.
Kip, thank you for the lightning bolt.
I can probably find a photo from those days, but...
Box about you've had. Yeah, I could probably find one.
Do I want to? No. No, I do not.
Hi, Daisy.
Hello.
Do, We'll make it sub exclusive. Wug.
Oh.
Still searching for the goldfish, yeah.
I was like, I just had that song in my head.
Mary, thank you for the follow. Curlier, we've had.
I'll check.
Yeah, we'll probably be here tomorrow doing this exact same thing. Sizzle.
Maybe slightly different. Yeah. Who knows?
Could use a different mat.
Oh, I did use a different mat yesterday.
You did. You used the Morpeko and
Marnie. I did look at that for a cosplay because that's just a pink dress and a leather jacket and a black wig, but you know, meh. What worries me is that at some point we will either leave the studio or I'll go work somewhere else and I'll have to remove my collection of costumes. Now, depending on how long that time frame is, will depend on whether I'm like, oh, nuts.
It's like working in a suit shop and having loads of suits that you don't wear to any other occasion because you don't need to wear suits anywhere.
Yep. That's exactly it.
Did we make the Paldean Fates binders ourselves like Chaos cards? What Paldean Fates binders?
There's a four-pocket portfolio. Yeah.
They are the official binders from Pokemon. We don't make any of those. Gloom.
Interestingly, on my phone, Daisy's comment comes before Gemma's, and on the screen, Gemma's first and then Daisy.
Gemma has big screen priority.
If Johnny did, it would be Wiglet inspired. How many outfits have I got?
Maybe we should wear a suit. I'm Giovanni.
You could do that.
No, I'm going to.
We could get you like a Persian somehow, or a meow. So, I've got Nurse Joy.
Squawkabilly.
I've got Jesse. I've got the monk.
Oh yeah, Daisy.
The Mimikyu.
Daisy, Pokemon do official binders for all of the sets. Nines and fours, and then some other ones too, based on similar to like playmats and sleeves and deck boxes. So yeah, they've got loads of their own official binders. I will say the Vault X ones are pretty nice. We don't stock them. The Pokemon ones are fine. They're on the cheaper side of binders, though. I'll tell you that.
So it all depends what you're after.
Yep.
The Arceus one was quite popular.
The Arceus one was nice. That one is a zip one. It's quite thick. The normal ones that come out every set are normally pretty standard binders. I don't think we've got any here.
Hang on.
Tentacool?
Let me go into the Beyond, because we did used to have one. It was an old one. Dang nabbit.
I think they're normally like plastic.
Yeah, I was sure we had one. Because it was an Eevee one.
Yeah.
No, it'll take me too long to find.
Like the 151 ones, yeah.
Yeah.
Similar. I don't know if those ones come with a elastic band or not. I haven't actually seen them. You do like the Game Genic zip-ups? There's loads of cool Game Genic stuff coming out. Are there any Fates folders? Yeah. There's Fates folios on the TikTok shop in the online store.
Yeah, I can pin those now.
Yep.
Now I've come back from the Beyond.
151 does. Oh, yeah, I know 151 has the elastic. We got that one. I'm not sure about the set ones.
No.
Because I have a Ultra Pro binder at home, which I think is very similar to those Pokemon ones. But yeah, the Game Genic stuff is pretty cool. We're going to see more Game Genic stuff for Star Wars Unlimited. Arkham Horror already came out with them. And maybe at some point in the future, Altered.
That's not how you spell portfolio. Nor is that.
How much are they? They're not too expensive. It depends where you're taking your binders, really.
Yeah.
If you are chucking them in a bag and then chucking them in the sea, I don't think that would be the binder that you should take. If it's going to sit on your shelf for
prosperity
500 years, then I'm sure you'll be okay. Pumbagiles, if we don't rip and ship, what are we? So before the rip and ships existed in the world, people opened products themselves and then sold the individual cards online. And that is what we do. So We open these for our single cards. We sell them on the web store. That's what we do.
Ta-da!
We're not a rip and ship. Favorite shinies from the set? The Luxray is quite nice, but I think I do really like the Charizard. It's really nice. The Iono is really nice too. We have Tinkertuff.
Tinkertuff?
Yep.
Tuff a Tink.
Oop. Pikachu. Pikachu's orange. It's spray tan.
Look at that. Saint-Tropez glow.
Where is Saint-Tropez?
No idea.
Oh.
I just know it's a fake tan.
Okay. Like the Essex glow.
Yeah.
Biscuit fake tan Pika. Yeah, absolutely.
So, I mean, Judge would be pretty cool to do as a cosplay.
Judge?
Judge. Green shirt with black bit on it and a whistle.
I don't have a whistle and I can't whistle.
You can't whistle?
I can't whistle. That's why I can't do Meg's thing where she whistles and then brings the product up. Can't do that. Can't whistle.
I appear not to be able to right now either. So
before ripping ships, we sailed the seven seas looking for Moonbrew.
Yeah, amazing.
To be fair, we did exist before ripping ships, so.
Not before the internet, but before a lot of live streaming was possible.
True. You can whistle, but not that well, Electri. Better than me. Oh, I know what I can do. I will clip Meg's whistle and then just put it in my videos and pretend to whistle.
Okay.
That's what we'll do. Next short unboxing I do. That's what I'll do. And then I'll say something like, hello, TikTok. how many packs have we ripped? We're probably like 1,600 odd.
Do you want to pass me the code cards?
I'll count on tomorrow. Count on tomorrow.
Yeah.
And then I'll soundboard. Then I'll get on the soundboard, snipe slurping some water. We'll get the whole gang going. Wiglet! Second Wiglet.
Of course.
You're meant to blow out whistling. You can only suck air in whistling. Yeah, I can't do either. How do you know Meg does the whistle and it's not a sound thingy? True. Maybe it is a sound thingy.
Because we've never considered that Meg would be using a sound effect.
No.
Congratulations, winner. The winner is you.
Sounds too convoluted for Meg.
Congratulations, Sam.
Cerulege. But is it too convoluted for me to do? No. Holy Seraphim, when you're happy to say you placed an order for the 3 Digimon TCG Animal Coliseum booster boxes with us. It's been a while since you last ordered something, but you're looking forward to them arriving, I'm guessing.
Mm.
Amazing stuff. Thank you so much. Good luck with your pulls. Ellsworth, you know, everyone wins every now and then.
Yeah. It's kind of a rotation.
Yeah.
Not that we pick who the winners are.
No. But it's all random. Just like the lottery. Amanda. We're not in London.
Oh, man. Right, we're looking for Relor and Slowpoke.
Mandem. Yep. What does it even mean?
I have no idea. I assume it's saying, like, you are, or that kind of thing.
Routes.
Not what we want.
Hi, Garif. How are you doing?
Hello.
No clue. Yeah, no idea.
I'm really paranoid that I've forgotten how to whistle now.
Paladin student.
Johnny was right.
Yep.
Yeah. See you soon, Holy Seraphimon. Enjoy your food.
Yep. I think it may be a roadman. What's a roadman?
Waste man.
Bin man.
We are never going outside. We are safe here in the studio.
They sweep the roads.
Mm. Oh.
In their little cars that swoosh.
Swoosh. So, and this is going to be difficult. Can't believe how few we've got left to get.
How many is it now? 7.
Let's count them up.
We could run the streets just like Saints Row.
1, 2.
GTA.
3. Kill a Wattrel.
Yep.
Man.
Got it. Which Saints Row, 4. Which GTA? Saints Row used to be great, and then they came out with a new one.
I think we're only missing... Oh, 5.
5?
5 including the gold.
Nice.
I watched The Criminal Minds yesterday, and one of the pseudonyms the killer chose was a character from GTA.
Dodrio!
Woo!
4 left. Saints Row 3 and GTA San Anxious. San Anxious is my favourite. No, San Andreas is great. I love San Andreas.
1, 2.
Saints Row 3 was great too.
3.
Saints Row 4 I enjoyed, but it was basically a glorified DLC. So.
Wait, what?
What? Code school.
I think I missed Dodrio.
Oh, you miscounted.
Yeah. 1, 2. 3.
20 yards. No, I haven't played the new 4. One, and I probably won't. Heard a lot of not great things.
5. Bad. So now we've only got 5 left to get. Previously we had 6, okay. Because I skimmed past Odrio, apparently.
Cool. Can I do Tekken spoilers? Does anyone care? We've only got 10 minutes left.
You're going to summarise all of Tekken?
Well, no, just 8.
Okay.
You remember when I... Did the previous... all of Tekken, right? Yeah. You remember everything I said.
Yeah, there's a panda and a bear.
Yep. That's all that you need to know, apparently. So in Tekken 7, Kazuya, who is Heihachi's son, ends up punching and killing his dad and then throws him into a volcano.
Deliberately.
Yep.
Yeah.
Something devil gene. Jin, who is Kazuya's son, also has the devil gene. He went and he awoke the original devil to fight because he wanted to beat it in a fight. So he awoke the devil by causing a world war and then beat the devil, so the devil went away. But he's really exhausted now.
There's a song called The Devil Went Down to Georgia, I believe. I feel like Tekken may have stolen that.
Tekken 8, Jin is tired. Kazuya killed his dad. Tekken 8 begins with Kazuya fighting Jin. They fight. Kazuya wins, Jin loses. He's sad.
Oh, poor baby.
But he's still alive. He goes, he's like, oh, I'm really sad. I need to find myself again now and stuff like that. So he goes into oh, another Dodrio. Just like a bus. Jin goes back home, basically. Sees his mum in a dream or something.
Is she dead too?
Yeah, okay. Sort of, maybe.
Who knows?
And then he realizes, ah, oh, he's got super angel powers.
Yep. Oh, but I thought he had the Weevil? Devil genes.
Yeah, he does.
Can I give you these? Sure. Because they're disturbing me.
Then.
Not those.
Long story short, he goes to fight Kazuya.
Yeah.
He's got super angel powers. Kazuya's got super devil powers.
Oh, I thought. So, wait. Who's got the devil genes?
They both do.
Okay, fine.
As
you were.
They fight. It starts off normal. Then it goes into a big Dragon Ball thing. Then they're in space and fight like a big Dragon Ball thing. Then
Tekken
they
has Dragon Ball.
Like, as
it looks.
Dragon Ball powers.
Yeah, fine.
Then they come back down to Earth and they have no devil powers or angel powers. And then they fight some more. And then Jin wins.
So the whole point is if you go out to space, you lose all your angel and devil genes. Cool.
Yep.
Don't go space, kids. Danger.
So Jin won. Kazuya's kind of unconscious or whatever, but maybe Jin's mum is alive.
But featuring dreams.
There's some other stuff in there, but yeah.
I heard no panda.
Panda's not relevant to the story. Neither is Kuma, unfortunately, the bear.
Disappointing.
But you can play their side story, and Kumastai's story, when he wins, he has a dream that he goes into space, I don't know why we're in space again, as an astronaut, to say that he loves Panda, who's also in space, but then Kuma's space astronaut helmet gets punctured, and so he goes away. But that turns out that was a dream.
Oh.
And he actually just lost the tournament.
That's how you deal with loss.
Panda's ending is that she now runs the Mishima Corporation, and she's looking for Jin. And so she gives an interview as well.
And Jin's not in space.
Jin's not in space. No. But Panda is a panda. Okay. And so when Panda growls at subtitles, which is quite funny. Yeah.
Good talk.
It's all right. The gameplay is very similar. If you went from Tekken 7 to Tekken 8, it's a very similar gameplay.
So have you completed it then?
Yeah, the story, yeah.
Oh, okay.
But there's always new characters and stuff coming out. We got some new characters this time around. Coffee Lady is from Peru, which makes sense. They have llamas there. And she's pretty cool. She was an MMA fighter.
Wait, what?
There's llamas there.
Yes.
Alpacas.
Was that relevant?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're in the background of a stage.
That makes more sense. I was like, why have we brought up the llamas with the coffee?
But she's Coffee Lady. What other new characters are there in this? Oh, we got Victor Chevalier, who's like a French secret agent, basically. He's pretty cool. He's voiced by someone, actually, who plays Robin Hood in Shrek, I think. Yeah, some cool characters. But I played Claudio, the Italian exorcist, in Tekken 7, and he was my main. Tekken 8, he's all right, but something's changed where I've just kind of gone a bit off. So I've retired him for a minute to play Steve, the British boxer, who's really good, and I've been having a lot of fun with Steve. He's cool because he doesn't really have a lot of kicks.
Sorry. So you've moved from Claudio...
to Steve.
The Italian exorcist.
Yep. To Steve the boxer.
Steve the British boxer.
Steve the British boxer.
Yep. I'm fine.
Yep.
I'm okay.
I'm
glad you've made that decision.
Trying to think of other characters that...
you're enjoying your new life with Steve.
Dabbled a bit with Lily, the French. I don't know if she's royalty.
Aristocrat,
maybe. Hi E, how's it going? Elisa, the robot, is pretty cool. Who else do I go with? I mean, I've played everyone because I played through all their own little stories.
Okay.
So you got.
All good.
Comme ci, comme ça. Hey. How are you doing? Don't know if that's French or Spanish or...
Comme ci, comme ça.
But they actually took out one of my favourite characters from Tekken 7, Miguel, who is Spanish, which is sad.
What was Miguel's professional hobby?
I think he was a bull fighter. I think. I'm not sure, actually.
Matador?
Yeah. I mean, his whole story revolved around Heihachi destroying the church where his sister was. I don't really know what his day job was.
Didn't come up.
His sister had been blown up by the Mishima torpedoes. So.
Wow.
There's also
no small talk.
Zafina, the Egyptian oracle, who put the power of the devil in her arm.
Just one arm.
The original devil. Yeah.
The OG devil.
The OG devil.
Not this new version
Afra.
2.
Yeah, we've been doing good. I'm just trying to think of other characters that are in there. It's weird because...
Stop that!
In the last game, we had Akuma from Street Fighter.
Far they're going, and they're so close to going down the edge of the table. I'm going to knock over all your piles.
Toxtricity.
Oh, Dan's playing Power World.
Power Worlds? Ah, Depresso.
So many Gibby Goblins.
So many Megs.
Oh, dear. So I'm looking forward to next week. For many, many reasons.
We've got Pokemon New Year.
We've got Pokemon, we've got Yu-Gi-Oh. We've got Lunar New Year. We've got Pancake Day and Valentine's Day. Mm-hmm. It's kind of falling into the week after, but, you know, a lot to be excited for. Five, six, seven. We're almost at 50k likes there.
Oh, thank you. Oh, there's also Yoshimitsu, the alien.
What does the alien look like?
See you later, Gemma. A ninja.
A ninja?
Yeah. It's got a sword.
Oh. I thought he'd have nunchucks.
So Yoshimitsu is pretty cool.
So an alien requires a sword. Do they beam in?
No.
Okay.
Ninja, he's like spins in. He's invisible.
Oh, he's an invisible alien.
Sometimes he goes visible and invisible.
Okay.
Who else is there? There is Martial Law, who is Bruce Lee. There is Paul Phoenix, whose hair used to go like this, but now it's down.
Hairspray ran out.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you trying to remember every character?
I'm trying to think.
Yeah.
I played as them all, and I can't remember half of them apparently now.
Mm-hmm. I'm guessing it doesn't take long to play as a game then.
No. I mean, every round will take like 2 minutes.
Okay, yeah.
You've got to be very quick.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Oh, there's King the Wrestler. Chiyu! There we go. We got it.
Ooh.
Chiyu, the gold rare.
Well, that feels better.
That is the big one. That is the rarest card that we were waiting for.
Ta-da!
There you go. And I think that's probably... That's probably it.
Yeah.
Chiyu. Right, so we're 4 left.
Yeah.
4 left. You're counting.
Of course I'm counting.
Always gonna... End?
Yeah. Bye. Nice to see you.
We'll see you later. Have an amazing evening, everyone. And bye-bye. See you tomorrow for more Paldean Fates.